Hey guys, welcome back. This is Inferno Canuck and another episode of Rise of Persia, my Spartan campaign. We're just reeling after the big battle for Argos. I have captured that city now. So for the next few turns, I think I'm going to just rebuild and reorganize. So it's nothing going to be too interesting, so I'll just show you the important bits when they come up. So we have a new husband for our famous princess, who's already, I believe, turned down about 5 suitors. Now this one is younger than her. Back at the beginning of the game, she was 31. She's probably pushing 40 now. And this guy's 30 years old. He's a good commander, he's a good attacker, and he's an oligarchist, which is great. Also, I now have one family member for every settlement that I have, so now I don't have too many, plus I'm just raking in money hand over fist, and eventually I am going to need a new governor, or maybe even a general, to continue to expand the empire, so I think I actually will accept this guy. He's the lucky fellow. Alright, as you can see, I'm making over 4,200 in profit, so I'm going to use about 2,200 and actually recruit some new forces to fill up Sparta, Argos, and all my other cities, create a real military presence. Alright, so we're going to do a massive amount of recruiting. For Elis, we're going to recruit 3 of these hoplites. In Sparta, we are going to recruit 2 of these elite Spartans. In addition to one of these Cryptia and 2 of these Javeliners. For Argos, we're going to have to go out into the fields and recruit, but we are going to recruit 2 Hoplites and 1 Javeliner and put them back into the city. And for Eretria, we're going to recruit 2 of these Hoplites and 1 javelin. So it'll take a few turns, but my military will increase substantially. Alright, Argos can't build troops of her own just yet, so we're going to try to get a barracks up and running as fast as possible. So first things first, we have to build a government building, which I'll do. Alright, as you can see, Athens, there's this faint gray line that's traveling all the way down to this coast here. I believe that's where Kyrene is, and it might be worth going on a trade mission to see if we can't get some trade rights from them as well. So I'm going to bring down my diplomat and put it right by my boat here. There are pirates nearby, so instead of going right away, I'm going to bring the boat to this port where it's safe, and in the meantime bring down my diplomat, and hopefully in the next turn those pirates will disappear and no longer be a threat. Also, while I'm down there, I can check out this island and see if it is autonomous or whether it's a part of a larger faction. Alright, I've made a decision. Even though I'm still in the middle of rebuilding and recruiting all my troops, I have a really, really huge opportunity right now. I can take out both Athens and Thebes by sieging both cities at once, as a surprise assault. It's pretty aggressive and pretty expansionist, but I don't think I'll have this opportunity again, and I have to jump on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this army, I'm going to have the young prince here, and you know what, I'm going to have my leader as well. I'm going to have them all jump up. Actually, before I do so, I'm going to just quickly double check and make sure there are no surprise forces anywhere else. I don't want to be ambushed by other Athenians or anything like that, but it looks like they only have their armies in their cities. So, as I said before, I'm going to take my entire force here and attack Thebes. Yep, I know it's a neutral faction, but now we are at war. I'm going to lose some money from trade because I won't be trading for Athens, but that's alright because, oh, in the next little while, I did not see this unit at all. This is a huge family member. I started a war here that I probably shouldn't have. This is what happens when you rush into it. I was a little too opportunistic. It is relatively weak still, though. So I'm going to continue on with my plan. I'm going to have these family members attack Athens, knocking out the faction leader and Athens as well. We're going to continue that siege. Now what we're going to have to do is do something a little bit on the desperate side, and I'm going to have to recruit some mercenaries to help me fight this, because these two coming in at once, it's going to be tough. So I'm going to recruit everything that I can just to ensure victory. I have the money, so I'm going to use it. Alright, it looks like we have a battle. Sure enough, this army isn't allowing me to just siege Thebes at will, so they've come out to attack me. Looks like we have an even army strength ratio, about the same amount of men on either side, except they're split up onto two forces. So we'll see how well I do in the battlefield. Strike down our foes with righteous anger. I really like the sound of that. So, looking at the battlefield, it appears that I have two options. I can either be defensive and head up to the top of the hill here, wait for them to come and meet me in case they consolidate, because they are the attacker, and I'm the defender. Or I can take this center ground and attack one force head-on before the reinforcements come on. I'm going to be aggressive, I'm going to take the initiative, and I'm going to try and attack them. Alright, so this is my deployment. I have a skirmisher line up front with of my archers. I have my two wings of cavalry in the back, just to anticipate to see what the foe is going to do. See what the Athenians are going to do. I have two lines. The center of my first line are my Spartans. On the far right are my elite Spartans in the place of honor, and on the left are the elite hoplites. In the second line, we have a reserve line of both generals, where they can really dig in when the going gets tough. We have my Cryptia. They're hiding on the left here in the tall grass, and they're going to just be a flanking force as well. Let's start the battle. Alright, so as we can see, the enemy reinforcements are coming from the northeast, and the smaller force is right here, so I'm going to run in and try to crush them as quickly as possible. So let's bring this these archers up forward quickly. We will bring them to about there, have them run. As for my line here, let me just group this up. Alright. I'm going to mass my cavalry and bring them on the right as well and try to strike out his cavalry as well. The line is going to run as well. Run to about this spot right here. Alright, I'm engaging their Toxitai. Their horses are coming out to disrupt my missiles. I'm going to bring my cavalry. Actually, my cavalry won't get there in time. So my cavalry is going to swing around on this end. And I'm actually just going to bring up my first line very quickly to meet them. And try to intercept the disruption to my missile units.